बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे इज द लेक्चर नंबर 14, डेमोंस्ट्रेशन ऑफ टर्म पेपर एंड आल्सो रिसर्च पेपर DPT 2, इंग्लिश कंपोजिशन एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन रिसर्च पेपर। First, the title you must write the title in front of this word, and title also contains address, paper title,
students by
while having a research study on a particular topic. So in the limitation of the study, he must also mention all kind of the sources of the information by which he collects or gathers information for the to support for the accomplishment of this research paper. So in the methodology section, he must or you must explain your methodology. What is the method of your research? What is the criteria of your research? And also, what is the limitations and what is the mechanism of your study? In what way you made a research possible to finding a particular kind of the important kind of the detail to support your topic in a form of the research paper. And then the last part of the body in a form of the conclusion. In this part, you must give all the arguments in the favor of your points. It means that by the arguments, with the help of the argument, you can also prove your thesis work, and also it can also make be very helpful for you for the accomplishment of your topic. So it is based purely based on the arguments, because arguments are this give a positive mood in the support of this title. So it is a basic rule of the English writing, in which I have already generally discussed that if you want to write in favor or disfavor, your arguments should be strong, because now the arguments are the fundamental keywords or key strategies which can also prove of your writing. So maybe it can also mold your visions, mold your attention. Maybe it can also make the favorable, and also it can also make the disfavorable. So argument is the main section of a research paper, which can also mold your study on a particular point, and also it can be very helpful to make it possible research work. So now the second part of today's demonstration is that the term paper. Experience, because definitely it is the outcome of your experience at any kind of the educational institutions in which you must. So first of all, you must write the topic. There are three important parts of a term paper: introduction, in favor of the this favor, because definitely you must write all positive positive aspects and also all kind of the shortcomings which you face at this spot. Because definitely now if you feel any kind of the misunderstanding, if you feel any kind of the misunderstanding while having a study on a particular topic, but definitely there were also certain reasons, so you must also mention of all those reasons. Maybe these reasons directly related to the student personality, and sometimes these reasons can also be related to the teachers, because these artifacts which can also create a hurdle and also play as a barrier in the process of the understanding. Because definitely now the environment can also affect very well in this way, in a positively and the negatively. Because definitely environment provides equal opportunity for all the students, but some students enjoy a certain kind of situation and also mold all the situation in their favor. But also sometimes the environment cannot be and also support them, but the students are unable to mold the situation in their favor, because in this way now the environment can also become another factor which can create a problem during this session. So now the last part is that in which the conclusion. So this is the last part of the term paper in which you must write something about in the form of the suggestion. You must also mention all shortcomings and also positive points and also all kind of the points which were not in your favor and also create a problem in the process of the understanding. It means that in the conclusion part, you must write all the positive and also all problems you mentioned in this way. So in a term paper you must write the title first, or on which topic you are also having a specific word. So basic, that is the only a very little difference between the term paper and also a research paper. So term paper can also be written in the end of the any terms, but and also cannot assign to you at any time. So there is no need to give a long list of the references in the term paper. So whereas in a research paper you need a long list of the references, and also you can also give a title to write at any time. So it may be on current issues, it may be on social issues, and also on the different topic. So a term paper is a short form of the writing, whereas a research paper is a long form of the writing. So in which there is no need to give the arguments, but in a research paper you must give a list of the arguments which can be molded and also change the situation completely in your favor. So in the conclusion you summarize all your experience in the base of the analysis. So analysis is a such kind of the vision, thinking and also method which chief object is to make it clear and also identify all the positive aspects as well as negative aspects. So by carrying out all the positive mood, it can also make clear for the which is purely going in the favor of the title, and also some negative aspects by avoiding of all those aspects, we can also make it clear and also make it useful for us. So dear students, today two topics are also difficult and practical demonstrations we have observed on the board: a term paper, writing style, writing method and writing way of the term paper, and a research paper. So keep remember that there is a very little bit of the difference between a term paper and a research paper. So you must apply if individual rules of the writing. You must adopt the rules of the term paper while you are writing a term paper, and you must obey the rules of the research paper while you are also writing a research paper. Thank you so much.